Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and welcome to another Raw Vlog. Now, if this is your first time watching one of my Raw Vlogs, this is basically a video where I get to be straight up with you. I get to be open and just kind of flesh out a topic that I may be thinking about or something that I may have noticed. So today I want to talk to you about asking someone for a favor. Now, the specific point that I want to highlight here, the specific point that I want to address is asking someone to do something when we know that they really don't want to do it. But we ask them because we know that they respect us and they'll do it anyway. Or we know that they would feel bad to say no, and so they would do it anyway, and therefore we go ahead and ask them. Now, this is not something which is okay, and this is not from good character that we ask someone to do something that they may not be comfortable with and or something that they may not want to do. But as I said, they feel compelled to do it because we're asking them. And it may be because someone is older, it may be because the person respects us, or maybe because, you know, they feel shy to say no. And it's particularly crummy on our part when we know, as I said, we know the person doesn't want to do it, and we know that they're only going to say yes or they're only do it because of who we are. Now, as I said, that's not okay, and that's from bad character to do that. And I know some people may say, well, is that haram? Is it something which is impermissible? Now, we need to understand that there is a difference between that which is permissible and that which is recommended or that which is preferred. So, you know, the Prophet ﷺ, he said, إِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُ لِأُتَمِّمَ صَالِحَ الْأَخْلَاقِ. He said, I have been sent to perfect good character. So it's not just like an average level of character that this is, you know, this is acceptable. We have to be at a higher level of character. We have to be at a higher level of interaction, especially as Muslims, that we need to be our best and we need to take into account how people feel. Now, obviously there's exceptions to this. There's always exceptions in these cases. So an exception to this may be like a parent and their child, for example. A parent tells their child, hey, go clean your room. Like, obviously the child doesn't want to clean their room, but this is their parent and they tell them to do it and they're going to do it anyway. Or, for example, we know that something is good for someone and therefore we ask them to do it. So, for example, someone says, hey, can you help me make a decision about something? And we say, hey, go pray istikhara, right? Go ask Allah for help in deciding. And they're like, yeah, I don't know if I really want to do that, but here we ask them to do it or we tell them to do it because we know this is better for them. These types of situations, these types of cases, they are the exception. But the default is that we never, ever, ever want to put someone in a situation that they're not comfortable with. We never want to make someone do something that they don't want to do. And another point here, by the way, it's important for us to understand that sometimes a person's reasoning may not make sense to us, or we may not fully understand someone's reasoning for being uncomfortable with something, and therefore we think it's okay to compel them to do it, right? Like, oh, they don't have a real reason for saying no, or they don't have a real reason for not wanting to do it, therefore it's okay for me to tell them to do it even though they don't want to do it. Just because we don't understand their reasoning, just because their reasoning doesn't make sense to us, it doesn't make it okay. And that's a principle for us in Islam, that taking advantage of anyone is not okay, even if it is in something that is permissible or something which is allowed. The fact that they don't want to do it, or they would feel uncomfortable doing it, or we sense from them that they're kind of uneasy with it, we shouldn't ask them to do it. So I want to hear from you. Number one, how do you feel about this situation? I know some people may disagree, but what are your thoughts on this? And as I said, asking someone to do something when we know that they don't want to do it and they would do it only because they respect us or they like us or they don't want to disappoint us. Second of all, as always, I'd love for you to share your experiences. Have you ever been put in that type of situation, or have you ever put someone else in that type of situation? So put it in the comments below, and I'm gonna try and get back to people, inshallah ta'ala. As I mentioned in my previous video, I'm trying to get more active in my videos, and I'm trying to respond to people. Usually the threshold is about a day or two, so the comments that come in the first day or two, I'll usually go in and check out the comments and try to respond. After that, sometimes it's hard to go back and respond to the comments, but if you leave a comment below, inshallah ta'ala, I'll try my best to get back to you and respond. And until next time, as always, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. Take care. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.